Tyson Geik of NLL Productions here with the captain of the Saskatchewan Rush, Chris Corbeil. Chris, let's start here. What happened in Game 1 against the Georgia Swarm in the Champions Cup, and what went wrong for your team?
Well, a lot went wrong. I think first and foremost, we had them a couple times on the ropes, and we let them back into the game. And I think if we find ourselves in the same opportunity on Saturday, we're going to have to find that killer instinct and put them out of the game. I think obviously the story was them hanging 18 on us. Our offense played really well, but our defense didn't get the job done, and our defense obviously has to make it a tougher time for their old guys in our end and start winning some battles, especially loose balls, rebounds, that kind of stuff, because quite frankly, when it came down to it in the second half, they just had too many possessions compared to our offense.
Now, the Rush are looking to make it a three-peat, but you've never been in this position before, down 1-0 in the Champions Cup. As a leader, what do you say to the guys on your team, and how do you lead them in this position?
Yeah, you know, we got a room full of leaders, so guys know what's expected. I'll just remind them of how rare an opportunity is, and that's sort of what my message was at the start of the series as well, is that, forget the three-peat. Just competing for an NLL championship is massive, and I think maybe our group takes it for granted because we've been fortunate enough the last couple of years to win. But a lot of guys go their whole career without the opportunity to play in one of these. So just to leave it all on the floor and have fun in the moment more than anything. We're going to be playing in front of a sold-out building in Saskatchewan. It's the most fun you're going to be having playing lacrosse in your lifetime. So just to really make the most of the opportunity and leave it on the floor.
Let's talk about that a little bit. I saw your tweet the other night talking about the Nashville atmosphere and environment down in the Stanley Cup final. How awesome is it going to Saskatoon and playing there? And how much does that add to your team, having that seventh man behind you, really supporting you? And how much of a difference is it going to make in Game 2 here?
Yeah, I mean, I hope it makes the world a difference. I think our home record speaks for itself when you look at, how well we've done this year playing at SaskTel. And, the energy that the crowd provides you is unbelievable, and lacrosse is obviously such a game of runs and momentum, and I think the crowd really contributes to that. So that'll all be playing to our favor on Saturday night, and I mentioned in our last question, it's a lot of fun playing in front of that many people, and when the stakes are so high, it all sort of compounds and makes for an awesome experience. So I'm really looking forward to it.
I'm sure there's going to be a lot of Rush fans watching this interview right here. Do you have a message for them heading into Game 2 and maybe what they can expect?
Well, expect a better performance out of us. And, I'll promise them we'll get the job done and force a Game 3.
Thanks a lot. That's Chris Corbeil of the Saskatchewan Rush. Chris, best of luck in Game 2.
Thanks a lot, Tyson.